All right. Hold on a second. I need a drink. Okay. I'm inside a grocery store because it's warm. I'm wearing several layers, although it looks like I'm not. But I dress like this when, see, when I'm outside going to do heavy exercise, so don't have all these hot layers on me. But right now I'm just standing, so I'm cold. I want to talk today about people who piss me the fuck off, right? Let me get another drink. You know, every day we have frustrations, I'm aware of that. I'm aware it's a normal thing. When I'm only on 4 hours sleep, because I went to the gym last night and went to bed late and got up early, frustrations get amplified. I organized a meetup today. I've been gone, you know, to Chicago, if you didn't know. And I came back, and people were asking about the meetups. And when it gets a little bit cold, they cancel. Last minute. I already know this, I've been doing this for a year and a half, and that is life. There may be one, two people coming. Maybe one that I know. Another person that I don't know. Maybe the person I know won't come. I still have to come. That's my obligation, that's my core values, you know? But I won't lie that it's frustrating. You know, people cancel last minute, people have their shit not in order, you know? And when it gets a little bit uncomfortable, people freak out and they cancel. That's sad. That's really fucking sad that people are so... useless with themselves. You know? How do you get to what you want in life without going through a little bit of discomfort? Exercise is not always going to be pleasurable. You just have to do things, you know? You have to trudge through things. It's not, of course we're sightseeing, but that's not the, it's a premise, you know? So. At the first sign of problems, people bail out. It's kind of like the stock market. What was it? The stock market crashed when Trump became president. You know, it's like at the first sign of problems, people bail out. It's such a sad thing. So. I'm no longer frustrated. I'm just sad. I'm sad for people. No, behave like this. It's not a thing that's gonna get you further in life, you know? And it's kind of okay. Because not everyone can be, you know, at the forefront. Not everyone can trudge through things. So, that's all the better for the people who do, you know, who get success through trudging through things. And when it comes to exercise, you get the enjoyment afterwards, a sense of accomplishment, and it's a long-term thing. Even just with setting yourself up with when you stick to your word and you do what you have to do, you made your promise and you're going to do something, it just gives you a better feeling of satisfaction that you're not a pussy, you know? But not everyone is like that, and I realize that as people get older, it gets even worse. They get set in their ways. Mr. Chicago, I've mentioned him several times, is very set in his ways. You know, at 53, he was a lot more spontaneous when he was younger. And people lose that spontaneity when they get older. I counted up for, you know, being older and wiser and smarter, that you have to think things through. Yeah, but you know, when you're too much in your head, you're gonna lose. You're gonna lose when you're too much in your head. Just come, do what you set your mind to do, deal with the situation, and you'll be fine. There's no danger. You're not going to die. We're not in Siberia where you're gonna get freezing cold. There's a chalet. There's, you know what I mean? It's like, it's sad. It's I'm not gonna say I've lost hope in humanity. You know, I'm the leader of the group because that's what I am, you know. But it is meetup. People lead meetup groups and they're not leaders either. So what is really sad is people will make more of an effort to go to their 9-to-5 because they gotta make their coins to pay their bills for their pathetic lives from paycheck to paycheck than to do something that's important for them, for their health, for their personal growth. That's pathetic. And once you become awake or realize that not everyone thinks like you do, you know, it's a lonely path, you know? There are some people who think like that, but not everyone. You gotta be able to motivate yourself. You gotta be able to live on your own. This is true. This is what me and Mr. Chicago have in common. And it's important that you're able to live on your own, live independently. And when you are with other people, you just cherish the moment, but you don't become dependent on them. I know this. But I won't lie, it's still a frustration. I'm gonna go home after this and sleep and eat. And see what I will do for the rest of the day.